This is the story of Peter and the Wolf. There is a bird, light and delicate, with feathers like silk. A dumb duck with a broad bill and large webbed feet. And a pussycat. She is smooth but greedy and vain. There is a wolf with sharp teeth and sharp claws who is always hungry. There are hunters searching the woods, firing their shotguns. There is a wise old grandfather. He worries about Peter all the time. And of course, there is Peter. It was early morning when Peter walked out of the house. He opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. On a branch of a tall tree sat the pretty little bird. "All is quiet and beautiful this morning," she said delicately. The bird was Peter's friend. Just then, the dumb duck waddled by. She was glad that the gate had been left open, as there was a deep pond in the meadow and she wanted to swim. Seeing the duck, The bird flew down and settled next to her. The bird, who was very sweet, said, "What kind of a bird are you if you can't fly?" "What kind of a bird are you," the duck said snappily, "if you can't swim?" And with that, she haughtily dived into the pond. Argued and argued, the duck as she splashed around in the water, the bird hopping angrily on the shore. Just then, something caught Peter's eye. The cat was stalking through the tall grass. The cat thought, "That bird is busy arguing. I can probably get her now." And on velvet paws, she crept even closer.
"Look out!" shouted Peter, and the bird flew up into the tree just in time. Well, the duck quacked angrily at the cat.
From the middle of the pond.
The cat walked round and round, looking up at the bird and thinking, "Is it worth climbing so high, I wonder? By the time I get there, she'll have flown away."
Grandfather came out of the house and through the open gate. He was puffing on his pipe. He never liked Peter to go out into the meadow. "Not really the place for you, grandson," he said gravely. "Wolves and things. You know anything about wolves? A dangerous lot, wolves." Said nothing. Of course he was not afraid of wolves, but he really couldn't argue with his grandfather. Grandfather led Peter home, and he locked the gate. Securely.
Mm-hmm.
sooner had Peter gone than a big, grey, hungry wolf came out of the dark forest. Turned and saw him. In a twinkling, the cat scampered up the tree. And the duck quacked hysterically, but in her panic foolishly jumped out of the pond. The wolf spotted her. He went for her like a shot. And no matter how hard, how fast the duck tried to run, she could not escape. The wolf in hot pursuit was getting nearer and nearer, catching up with her. And then he got her and swallowed her hungrily with one enormous gulp. This is how things stood. The cat was up a tree, sitting on one branch. The bird up the same tree on another branch. But not too close to the cat. There was no great affection between them. The wolf walked round and round a tree, staring at the both of them with greedy eyes. He was licking his hungry chops. Peter saw it all, thinking, so the wolf wants one of them. Well, two can play this game. I'll trap him. Yes, that's how it should be done. That's how it must be done. So Peter went to his room and found a strong rope, which he worked round and round smoothly until he made a noose. He slipped it through his fingers and tried one or two quick throws. He went out and noiselessly climbed up the stone wall over which one of the branches of the tree stretched.
Silently, he took hold of the branch. And eased himself onto the tree. He whispered to the bird, "Be a good little bird. Fly down and tease the wolf a bit. Not too close. Just enough to keep him busy for a moment or two." The bird obeyed and fluttered overhead, almost touching the wolf. Upwards and sideways, snapping his huge, sharp teeth. But she was a clever little bird. And the wolf couldn't catch her. Meanwhile, Peter took the rope firmly in his hand, and without the wolf knowing it, he slid the noose over the wolf's tail ever so gently. His might. Done! The wolf was caught. Caught by the tail, the wolf jumped wildly, trying to escape. Peter tied his end of the rope to the tree. So the more the wolf struggled, the tighter the noose became. Just then, Peter saw the hunters come striding out of the woods, moving towards him. Their double-barreled shotguns gleaming in the sunlight. Poised and ready. "Shooting!" Peter shouted, but the hunters couldn't hear him. "Put your guns away. Birdie and I have caught your wolf. Now take him to a zoo." "Zoo.
Victory Parade. Peter at the head. Followed by the hunters leading the wolf. At the rear of the column, the cat and grandfather, still puffing on his pipe and shaking his head quizzically. Well, and if Peter hadn't caught the wolf, what then? But, he decided to let it pass. Pussy said nothing. Above them flew Birdie. She was quite pleased with herself. Just look at what Peter and I have caught, she chirped. And if you care to listen, you might still hear that dumb duck quacking away inside the wolf. You see, in his hungry attack, the wolf had swallowed her alive.